push the bottom cylinder adapter back onto the pump cylinder. Make sure the writing is in the correct direction. Push the piston and piston rod into the pump cylinder. Now push the cylinder adapter on the top of the cylinder. Place the top cylinder on top. And put the bellow back in its slot. Use some water and soap to lubricate the bellow and twist it down onto the piston rod. Ensure it is completely in its slot. Now, place on the bottom cylinder, making sure the inlet on the bottom cylinder housing is facing the left, and the outlet from the top cylinder housing is facing the right. Place the bellow retainer, piston guide bush, and O-ring back onto the piston rod. Take the yoke and push it down onto the piston rod. Ensure it is far enough down to match both the holes in the yoke and the piston rod. Place the braces and bolts back onto the yoke. Make sure the bolts are placed in the correct way. The side used to tighten the bolts with the Allen key should be on the front, the completely flat side of the yoke. Tighten the bolts using the Allen key. Place the yoke guide back onto the piston rod. Take the pump to the pump frame and place it back, ensuring the bearing is entering the yoke and the yoke guide is in its slot. Secure the pump by tightening the wing bolts. Screw the wing bolts with even force. Alternate tightening in a cross pattern. The bolts should be hand tight. Twist and push the air vessels back on. Turn the flywheel a few times and secure the yoke guide. The yoke guide should only be secured after the wing bolts have been placed back and tightened. And finally, test the pump by turning the flywheel by hand to ensure the pump is working correctly.